Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back once again to the StarLadder StarSeries Season 14 here for North America. Now, jumping into our one and only match for this evening, it's going to be a best of three between the new FollowEsports roster and Coastless, the team that was previously Coast but now retains the sort of title and the Pro League spot. When you look at the SLECA Pro League, they're not the current Coast, but they're calling themselves Coast, ex-Coast slash Coastless for now. My name is Blue, I'll be your host for this evening, and joining me is Mega Man. Mega Man, how you doing tonight, man?
Oh, baby, I'm doing good.
Ready to cast some more games?
Absolutely. Now, obviously, we're starting off here on Mirage, going to be the first map of this BO3. I don't really see FollowEsports having too much of a problem in this matchup. The only thing that's really going to stand in their way is the stand-in for the Coastless side, Char. Very capable player in his own right, and a nice asset to have there on the Coastless side. So we'll see. We'll see how they kind of adjust to having a stand-in here. It's going to be a little bit interesting. Peter with the AWP for FollowEsports should be able to lock down some avenues. Stewie2k in a lurk role should be pretty awesome, as well as entry fragging. But you actually see Coastless take that knife round, so they're going to get the pick of the litter. They're going to get the start on the CT side, which is going to at least give them a little bit of confidence moving in here, as it is the slightly more favored side. But again, you know, FollowEsports, they give them the firepower edge over the Coastless squad.
Yeah, and in case anybody was curious, by the way, as to what the circumstances were surrounding this fill-in, I believe he's filling in for lemz, which was a player that joined it when the rosters kind of got mixed up after that drama that happened a few weeks ago. I personally don't know too much about lemz, but from what we were seeing of, it wasn't like he was a super important fragger, so missing him I don't think is going to be too big of a risk. And as you had just mentioned there before, bringing Char onto the roster, who actually is somewhat of a well-known name in North America if you sort of follow the scene pretty heavily, he might be able to do some pretty nice fragging power tonight for the Coastless side.
Yeah, the big part about lemz is his inconsistency. We saw him the other night in the Pro League that he had a tremendous match one map, and then the next map I think he was actually like 0-17 before he got a kill. So one of the things that he's struggling on, obviously, is a little bit of consistency. And hopefully he can get that fixed. Hopefully he's not actually off the roster and this is just because he couldn't make the matches tonight. But we are live in the pistol round. Coastless is going to be on the CT side. That's FGB, draWsouL, inVert, ScrunK, and Char, facing off against Peter, aKis, rooRoo, Stewie2k, and Slemmy. And they just gave up Cat for free.
And look at Peter here too, getting very, very close indeed to ScrunK as he slowly creeps up onto him, gets behind him, but going to completely miss the opportunity to catch that shot. Nonetheless, cutting off the reinforcements for the time being, but coming up right behind him here in a second. inVert might have a chance to take him down. ScrunK's actually going to find the kill, but as we had mentioned before, with Cat being allowed for the T's to take it for free here, we are going to see them very swiftly taking control of that B site, maintaining it for the time being here too. There is a fairly quick attempt to make a retake here from the Coastless side. Both players will be working their way in from Cat. There's going to be ScrunK picking up a kill over here on the Stewie to take him down. The team pressing forward, but Slemmy picking up a kill back over on the ScrunK as well, and now it's just inVert. He's going to get cut off by rooRoo from inside of Market, and FollowEsports will pick up the pistol.
Really nice play there for FollowEsports, obviously, just getting in there once they realized the site was clean, just motoring on in. The CTs went for a little bit of a pinch over there in the B-Halls, and it actually didn't work out for him in the long run, so capitalizing on the mistakes. Ghostless going to be down 0-1 here, and really, that was kind of a weird strat there from the CT side, just kind of giving up that B-bomb site for free and not really having any mid-presence whatsoever, because those players that did make it into the B-bomb site were on full HP, no damage being dealt prior to them pushing in, and you actually saw, I believe it was Stewie2k jumping all the way through the market window and finding first blood on a player rotating into B. So a little bit of a mistake there from Coastless. I don't think that was necessarily an unplanned thing, but it does end up biting them in the rear in the end.
And we're going to see a very, very small investment coming out now from the side of Coastless. Not going to go for the big 5-7 armor buy-up and whatnot that you sometimes see on the second round here. Really not going to be looking to resist anything as much here. We do see a couple upgraded pistols coming in, specifically on Char and FGB, as they go for both a Deagle and a CZ respectively. But FollowEsports still just taking it nice and slow and already sort of forging their way here into the A site. They've picked up one frag over onto inVert, which was the only player here. They tried to work for the Gambit play, four stock in the B site, but it just doesn't really pan out so well. And now they're starting to already clean up more and more of these kills. A little bit of damage over here on rooRoo as he takes a little bit of battle by the crawl space, but now Peter pressing his way in through Cat should be able to maintain things pretty easily, and it looks like that's indeed going to be the case. He's leaving FGB alive at this point.
Yeah, and he's not going to be alive for much longer. Stewie picking up three that round. Just overall, solid round. FollowEsports, no rebuys necessary. Slemmy still on the MAC-10. They still have the rifle power behind the rest of their players, so one of the big things to note moving forward would be to watch Stewie2k and how he entries into some of these sites, because he is the entry fragger for the Follow Esports site, and he actually does it relatively well. I know that there was a video, I don't know if you saw it recently, that Steel put out about, you know, natural talent when it comes to sports and esports and things like that. And definitely Stewie's one of those players that kind of just sprung out from nowhere. And young gun, and he's definitely got a lot of talent behind himself, and you can see it right here as they're cleaning up this this mid presence here from the CT side.
So again, not really too much else coming out from the members of Coastless this time around with their very minimal investment. Drossel is going to be the final player alive. He does line up that headshot there to take down Stewie, but now he's been revealed as to where exactly he is. So as he jumps around over there inside of the jungle, rooRoo is going to be able to dispatch him without any further kills. They almost found Peter too, as you can see. He was down to just 1 HP, but that's not going to happen. So once again, only going to lose two players. A very small amount of losses for the T side, with their economy being a lot more forgiving to those deaths. And now, of course, we're going to shift into the first gun round. And they've got everything they need here with them, going very, very light on those two eco rounds. We're going to see the op with armor here on inVert right from the get-go, and everybody else with M4s and full utility.
Yeah, Peter's got an up as well to contend with. He's going to be over there just watching for that A-ramp push. Turtled up defense here in this A-bomb site. You can see Drossel just watching for that Hall's push. ScrunK playing from the backside of triples, just looking for any kind of presence in his area. And actually missing that op shot was invert, or yeah, was invert there from the CT spawn. So that smoke isn't going to cover that area, so he's going to get free reign onto rooRoo. Drossel picks up Stewie. So this push coming into this A-bomb site is kind of getting stalled out. The rotations are already on. You can see FGB coming around here from the jungle side. Drossel does take down Peter before he gets traded, and it's all just down to aKis as Slemmy falls. So not the best gun round looking from Follow Esports. Nice job from Coastless on that A defense.
Yeah, Coastless just basically lined up exactly where I need to be for that under area there too, posing a little bit of a threat for the player that did end up coming in through connector. They were able to easily dispatch that. They eventually trade him out, but unfortunately too many kills had gone by the ways of the CTs at that point, and it was a fairly simple cleanup there, what was essentially a 3-on-1 at the end. So they picked that one up. Now they're going to go for, on this T side here, a little bit of a gun trade being had here, so Peter can get the op into his hands. But the CTs picking up the fallen one, they're going to be able to get ScrunK with his op coming off of Peter's corpse there now, so they've got a free double op setup being worked because of that last play.
Yeah, and that's dangerous because ScrunK is a pretty solid opper. Even though he plays with, you know, 100 ping from over in Europe right now, he is the German player that's playing with Coastless right now. And it doesn't seem like ping is all that effective on him. He does go for the AWP over the rifles most of the time just because it's a little bit easier with a one-shot, one-kill kind of deal. But, you know, this is an alt-friendly map, so Peter really needs to step up for the Follow Esports side. He needs to be able to get those opening picks and really work that off. And open up some avenues of attack here for the terrorist side. Unless he can really be successful, it's going to be a little bit more difficult as they dry run into these with that AWP kind of hindering their pushes into these bomb sites.
Now invert here too. I get a little bit of heat from connector, but he does decide to shift his position further over towards the window room to watch out for a potential boost in there. Peter as well, given a lot of freedom of movement back over here on cat as he tries to look and see what's going on to that B site. The bomb actually already committed back over here inside of A as it comes back up T ramp, but thankfully FGB holds. Unfortunately, he's going to end up getting traded out, and invert did pick up a kill on a Peter as he got a little bit too aggressive there. So now we see the CT's picking up two, but some nice shots coming out from the T's now. They're going to find three, and Stewie specifically with that very good one shot to take down draWsouL. He's only ScrunK and Char left alive. It is a 2-on-2, so I imagine they're going to go for it, but a great pick from Rue. The aim, not as much, but he's still going to be able to pick up the kill. Leaves himself 15 HP, and it's just ScrunK now. Not a whole lot to get back in, but he gets that shot out of Rue anyway, and now we've got a little bit of a match here for himself. He's going to move in. He's going to try to find out exactly where Stewie's positioned himself, which right now is underneath of the cat platform. Now trying to sneak his way back out. Got to be very careful against that up, but ScrunK picks up the shot anyway. He's going to clutch it out for Coastless. He's got the kit, and that's going to be a second point going onto the board now for the CTs.
Big 2v1 for ScrunK, big 3k on the round for him as well, so nice job from him. And it looks like they've actually got a little bit of a pause here from the CT side, not sure what that's about, maybe a little bit of a, there you go, sound problems, a little technicality going out, but good round from Follow Esports. They got into the bomb site, they got the trade kills, they were able to neutralize that AWP over by jungle and get in and get the bomb plant, but unfortunately for them, ScrunK comes up big in the long run and takes care of business. So 2-3 is going to be your scoreline. Follow Esports still on top, but their money is kind of in shambles now, so it looks like they are going to have to go for a save.
And now as we take a look at exactly where Follow Esports will be positioned this time, we can see, as you've said already, B250s coming out, smokes here and there, so probably going to be a quick take to get the plan and then see if they can hold from there. Coastless, unfortunately, that last round, although very well clutched out, isn't really going to do their economy any favors either when we look at the buys that they'll be going for in this round. ScrunK probably the only player that's going to be sitting at a high amount. The rest have to go for complete rebuys. FGB should be in a good position too, but for everybody else, probably going to be sitting at very close to or just under $1,000. Not going to leave them in a very solid position at all if Follow Esports are able to consistently pick up kills, especially here on the eco.
Yeah, we'll see where they decide to go here on Follow Esports' side, but again, actually, ScrunK is going to yield the AWP over towards Invert. Looks like he's just waiting for a rifle to come back around, and that's exactly what's going to happen. So, it was a one-and-done double AWP setup there. Don't really want to go too heavily invested on this anti-eco round. They should be able to clean some stuff up. I'm surprised that we didn't see him pick up an SMG of some sort, because they got to know that they broke the money of Follow Esports, and they could just go on a little bit of a farm to try to get that extra economy going, but... Coastless, you know, bringing it back. Ever since that first gun round, they pick up two gun rounds in a row. They have forced the eco out of Follow Esports, and this is where that economy game starts to play a big part.
Now as we take a look at where exactly the members of FE are going to take it, goes right into the back B push, working their way over there towards the getting inside of the apartments. As we mentioned as well before, probably going to be a very quick attempt to get into that site. Most players positioned just outside of the halls at the time being. Peters press forward in case the CTs get aggressive, but now those smokes and flashes should be coming in at any moment. And then they'll go right for this take, as we can see right now. One gets tossed over. This is going to be an attempt to sort of see if they can catch anything extra at the beginning, but won't be happening. Now the rest come in, and they're actually taking it very, very slowly here to see if they can catch any of the positions now and see if they get any jerk reactions out from the CTs, but they move in. They're actually going to rotate more CTs over. It was an attempt to think that it was going to be a fake, but that's not happening as they roll in. Peter picking up a very nice first shot, now upgrading himself to an M4. Smoker tries to smoke out the window, but it kind of bounces off the corner there. That's not the way he wanted to work that one out. Char still in sight, but he gets executed. Peter finds a really good corner now. He's going to find Invert as well, and they might just be able to pull off this eco round, to be honest. DrawSaw, he's back at top mid. He's falling back to save now, and ScrunK, although he pushes back, he's going to find one kill. Kind of goes for that reload for some reason. And
he's out of bullets.
Yeah, well, he was out of bullets there, so... Now we're going to get
your
the trade
overlay
on that.
Can't tell because you don't have the health and
There we go. The art hustler. I don't know. Something's messed up with my config, I think, and it does that, but
it's just a good TV thing.
DrawSoul is going to be the last one alive. Should be able to save as everybody from FE is heading back over there towards CT, but that's going to end that round and Follow Esports pulling off the eco.
Yeah, that's a big win for Follow Esports right there. I mean, obviously, they get out of it. DrawSoul, the only one alive with an M4. They're going to be resetting the money on the CT side. After a two-round win, they didn't really have too much to go off of because a couple of those rounds were so close. ScrunK getting that 1v2 and saving the AWP. So this time around, it's going to be a full economy for the Follow Esports side and a save for the CT. So Coastless kind of on the back foot now. They're looking at a 5-2 scoreline, and now DrawSoul is just going to be resting with this M4. And he's going to be able to find a little bit of damage early in the round, but aKis is just going to sit there stalwart, wait for that re-peek from Invert, and actually finds a nice frag onto him.
Pretty surprising they re-peeked that, considering just how many people they saw. So Peter is going to pick up that kill, or actually aKis will find the kill, but Peter at a heavy cost to his own life. He's down to just 1 HP now at this point. They're going to toss all their nades in and whatnot. Two players are going to stick behind to go for the entry, and this works out perfectly in terms of trying to draw the fake for rotations, which is going to work out now, as although we see FGB again getting some damage, no kills coming out just as of yet. Finally, he finds one, but he's also drawing the attention of Char, who's just going to fall on Stewie, although he gets knocked out too. Now these teams are just wrapping into the B site. They've already pretty much got control. FGB probably is going to be able to get a free gun off of the hinges of this, but still, the round will be going by the way of FE. Bomb has
been planted. Yeah, not a whole lot that Coastless can do on this round. Obviously, Stewie just barreling out the halls, picking up three kills. Nice job from him. You can see he's sitting at 10-5, so he is the leader on the scoreboard right now. And FGB, he's going to be holding on for dear life. They do have a little bit of a hunt going on as RooRoo's coming around. He's got money for a rebuy if he so desires, if he loses his AK here. So it's going to be fascinating to see whether or not he actually chooses correctly. It looks like he is coming up towards Palace, just creeping his way in. That's where FGB is. Doesn't spot him. He's in that back corner. FGB's not looking for this right now. So if he clears this, he might be able to take him down. He's not going to clear his angles. FGB just hiding in the corner. They walk right by each other. And FGB picks it up at the very end.
So now with us heading into this next round once again, and Follow Esports forging their way back into this, of course, Coastless They've got this one M4 in play. They're going to be able to buy up an additional one, so this will actually press its way into a semi-decent buy-up this time around. Char, the only player that isn't actually going to have an M4, but he's got Henna and whatnot behind it. Invert is the big story now, because he's gone for the op pickup, and he doesn't have any armor sitting behind it, so especially with how aggressively FE are playing this, he's going to have to try to time these shots perfectly. I hope he doesn't end up getting hit there first, as that's immediately going to throw off his aim, and it's going to be very hard to stabilize from that point without the armor, but Slemmy, he finds the first kill. Char is able to pop outside of the ladder room and find a trade for this, but now aKis, he's going to try to press forward too. Does find a nice headshot on the Skrunk, but Invert also getting some damage in here with the upper within that site. Peter catches the trade. Those are the T's. Once again, do have the sort of man advantage and the initiation advantage here too, as they just press their way into that B site. There's Char picking up the trade. Drossel finds one as well, so just like that, they turn the tables, and now it's on aKis, who unfortunately is going to end up getting flanked and cornered there to allow the CTs to pick up another round.
The big problem, though, is Coastless with two alive. Their economy still really, really reeling right now. So another full buy is going to come out from the Terra side with that bomb plan. You can see they've got a couple of players. Slimmy's up at 9,600. He's only 4-3, but he's been playing the economy game properly. So he's going to have a lot of money here. Probably going to see him drop a rifle over to aKis. So they will have a full buy behind this on the Follow Esports side. And this is where things get a little bit dicey for Coastless. They did pick up another round, but they lose this. Their money is still broken. So they're going to be right back on a save. And Follow Esports should be able to capitalize and go up to maybe a 7-3 scoreline when all is said and done, which is really, really scary for Coastless because they're on the verge of losing the half at that point. And when you're on the CT side, definitely not something that you want to be worrying about so far.
Yeah, and overall, another problem that we've been noticing too is that Follow Esports, obviously, again, for the most part, Coast in the late round situation do seem to be able to trade, but oftentimes, as we see with a lot of sort of new form CT side defenses from a lot of these teams here on more difficult maps to play, like Mirage, we do see the big problem is that there's just the rotations are not getting called quickly enough, so these teams can just play these super aggressive strategies. They get themselves into the site, and there's no rotation. There's not a whole lot of game sets going on. Like, there might be a shift coming in this way, so we need some additional support. And unfortunately, because the T's just take control so quickly, a lot of these rounds just go by the way of FE because Coastless has to call the save because there's no way in hell they're going to be able to make the retake. We're seeing this again with this game, and Peter is going to burn alive here right at the beginning of the round. Somehow, he had a smoke down, but it, like, I don't know if it was a TV bug or whatnot, but somehow he had the smoke down, but the Molly was still killing him, so that's a little odd. As I don't think he actually should have died there.
I don't think he believes he should have died either, if you look at his MM1 going on there. But yeah, it all comes down to Slemmy, last man alive. He's going to be in the B-bomb site and at least takes Char with him, so he's going to try to make this as expensive as he can, but,
Peter basically died from secondhand smoke. is what really happened there.
Oh, boy.
This is a PSA.
I don't know. There was an update that went out. I don't know if they changed anything. I don't know why Valve does that. They put out an update in the middle of a major. It makes no sense to me. None. They've done that before, and it makes absolutely no sense. Or put out a temporarily game breaking update like the week before a major. So.
But in all seriousness, he actually should not have died there. For people
who
are saying, like, PJ Sauda or whatever, no, he should not have died there. He did throw smoke at a Molly, and for some reason it still burned him. So, getting back into this game, of course, FE, now on a broken economy once again. Coast is starting to establish themselves a little bit, but they just go for the quick play to try and get the extra money so they can get into the next fire on quickly. They are picking up a couple additional kills here, too. aKis is up to two, but he finally gets traded back out there by Invert. Stewie's going to find one more as well, but now he's in a one-on-two. Hasn't been able to find an upgraded rifle just as of yet, but brings Invert down pretty low. He's going to win the shot. Pops back out, looking to kill him with his pistol, and now Char comes in to save the day.
So 5-5 now, Coastless going to tie things back up here. 10th round now behind us, coming into the 11th. It will be another buy round here, but again, they made it expensive there for the CT side. You see only two rifles coming out of that, so even though they're stringing a couple of rounds together, it's just very, very difficult for them to get any kind of momentum going because they're behind these kind of weak buys. They do have a decent buy behind this. They've got full nade kits and full rifles, so this one isn't bad, but they lose this one, they're going to be right back on the save, so it's just a moment of... Well, there it is. Stewie2k opening things up. Invert down.
Invert, for some reason, you could see where he was aiming. He, like, didn't think he had got himself in a palace that quickly, but you can even hear the footsteps on our side, so for some reason, he just doesn't catch that at all. So Stewie picks up the kill. Draw's gonna get right into his face here through the smoke to see if he can catch him, but it doesn't look like they're gonna meet each other just as of yet. Draw maybe working through it now. He can hear those nades getting tossed out, but he's just gonna sit nice and steady as the rest of his team works in. Unfortunately, Peter's gonna catch him as that smoke does start to fade, so he is gonna get eliminated. ScrunK finds a trade, but again, these T's are just so good with the take, and the defense for Coast is just not panning out at all. rooRoo is gonna clean things up with a nice headshot there on a cat, and FB pick up yet another round. Coast is doing a good job of keeping things close, but we still have the T's in the lead here on Mirage, which is not what you wanna have.
No, not at all. They're going to force up here on the CT side, and this is kind of a necessary evil that they've gotten themselves into. They need to be able to win these rounds. They need to win the half. Obviously, predominantly more CT-sided map than terrorist-sided. Now, we've seen some big T-side halves come out, but that's not really the meta on this map. And you can see now Invert is actually going to get boosted up into the B halls, and they actually boosted him through the window, which is a nice little place because that catches Peter completely off guard. Char wants to push forward and get this gun, too. That would be massive.
So he's gonna
and the bomb's down.
Yep, and he's going to find that in a second here, too. Follow Esports actually really slow to catch this now at this point. So Slemmy and the rest of FE, they're not going to push forward through middle a little bit. And like we said before, they've got mid control. Thankfully, Char actually doesn't notice this bomb, so they're going to be able to fall back and pick that up. But that could have been a really huge scavenge there if he was able to find that and call the rotations over. But he's going to take the safe path, decides to fall back. And now FE, once again, sort of get themselves back on their feet here. Unfortunately, down into a 3-on-4 at this point, but they still have, for the most part, a decent gun advantage. You're still looking at only two rifles for Coastless, along with two pistols beyond this as well, but they've got to find a way to get themselves into a site, and thankfully it looks like they are going to line themselves up for an A push now, as the number 7 player, aKis, he's gotten himself into connector, not really being challenged at this point, and the other two are going to try to wrap their way in from the T-ramp, but draWsouL here playing that forward position just on T-ramp, he's going to catch this play a little bit earlier on, and now the rotations can come in a lot faster.
Yeah, it's really going to be on aKis right here. He has to come up big. FGB coming around the corner, he's going to find that kill. Skunk still from the CT spawn, Char over here by jungle, he's got to get this right. Char's going to swing on him, takes him down, and it's all on rooRoo, who falls to draWsouL. Nice play from draWsouL, actually. Very patient over there at that A-bomb site, calling in the reinforcements, not over-peaking himself. And he actually picks up two with the 5-7. So Coastless, that was a must-win round for them to try to get a little bit of stability here on their CT side. So tying things back up 6-6, coming into the 13th round, we've got three rounds left to play in this half, and we'll see whether or not Coastless can actually take the half.
And of course, a big buy-up from them once again. Same story for FE, but they're starting to get a little bit low here too. Slemmy back down again over onto a Galil. So both teams sort of running on risk of an eco here if they drop this one. I imagine FE might be able to force through, but considering it'll be the 14th round, they might avoid it. And there's Invert again. Hop place in just the wrong spot, but thankfully ScrunK and FGB are going to be able to pick up the first two kills. And then Invert will be given the time to correct his aim to find a third. Peter and rooRoo are going to be the final ones left alive in flight. Peter actually not being spotted just as of yet, but the smoke is going to be a dead giveaway, of course. And for rooRoo, he's on a little bit of a quest himself, trying to get his way up on a cat to find that bomb placement. Works his way out. He does pick up the headshot there to shut down Invert, but FGB will still be challenging him back over there from cat.
Actually, rooRoo finds the second one. Peter, I don't know if he spotted the gun barrel there. He might... Oh! Well, he found ScrunK. That's going to be it for him. Now it's just down to rooRoo. They know where he is. He's got 100 HP still, so he could maybe make something work. And Char's going to try to make sure that that doesn't happen as he's playing over there from window room. draWsouL peeks out, actually loses his life, and now Char trying to hold this angle. rooRoo knows it, and he's just going to drop off cat, try to work his way up an A. He's got the CT split, so this could be a big play, but unfortunately Char's going to read that one properly and find that frag, so that will be a 7th round now for Coastless as they take their lead 7-6, and not quite done yet. It is going to be another save round here for the terrorist side, but they're going to be able to bolster that economy for the final round of the half.
And they're actually going to go for a pretty aggressive buy-up here, too. At least specifically on Peter, he goes for the Tech 9 armor buy-up. The rest of the team, I think, is just going to go for P250s, and Stewie will find an additional Tech 9. But no armor behind the rest of those guys, so that might have just been a misbuy or a miscall there for Peter to work with. So he's obviously going to be a little bit lower than the rest of his team. But for everybody else, they should still be able to get a buy on that final round as they work their way in. Invert already popping some shots over there by Ticket Box. That Molly doing some more work there, too. aKis down to 66. draWsouL picking up a kill at this point. Yeah, the CT's just cleaning up. Unfortunately, not a whole lot of luck from FE on these. On these ecos here. They do manage to plant the bomb, so again, that's going to give them the extra 800, but still a very, very clean anti-eco round here coming out from Coastless once again.
Yeah, but the mission was accomplished. They really just, you know, they won an eco round prior in this matchup over the B-bomb site. This time, the last two ecos that they were on, they went towards A, just went for the smoke plant, got the bomb down, got the extra money. Still don't have an op in the hands of Peter because he went for that armor tech 9 buy, so that was a little bit of a risky play, but he hasn't really been too terribly effective in this matchup. He's sitting at 8-10. It's really been Stewie who's been doing a sensational job. Nice leg shot from ScrunK in the mid. That actually finds good damage onto Peter, so that's a nice find early on for the Coastless side, but we'll see if they could capitalize on it moving forward. You can see they've actually got three Zeuses here on the CT set as well, so that's kind of fun.
I think at that point, just trying to spend all the money they can, basically, in hopes that they would get a chance to use it, so... Now for the rest of FE, going for something that, to be honest, it's usually been left up to a single player's job, with the exception of one or two rounds, which is going for this very aggressive kind of pick control. Stewie tries to forge his way back outside of back outside of Palace there too, but unfortunately he's going to get shut down. But so far the trade's coming in pretty evenly, and this is going to leave FE in the advantage spot. Now the rest of Coastless slowly trying to work their way back around. Invert, we can see, jumping up on a ticket box. He has been spotted by Ruru, and Invert going to completely whiff that shot. So Ruru hadn't seen him before, he knows he's there now, and Invert finally going to connect on the third attempt there. Slemmy's fallen back. The big problem is that he's down to 8 HP there, and he's going to lose his teammate now as aKis finds the kill back over there by Connector. So he's got to try to find a way back in, trying to take the shots at typical positions, but this is going to be a very, very hard thing to work for here. Just creeps his way in. Thankfully, aKis not directly speaking just as of yet. And the smoke comes out, but now they're just open firing on that bomb plant position, and as he presses forward once again, not really going to be able to take anybody down, and Slemmy's just going to finish things off there to bring Follow Esports back up to his 7th point here as they end the half.
Yeah, Follow Esports, 7 rounds on their T side. That should put them in a prime position to be able to take this first map. Now, do you know who chose which maps?
Okay. So this was the choice from FE right here. Our next map is the choice from Coast, which is Inferno.
Gotcha. And the Constellation map?
That will be on Dust 2, randomized, of course.
Okay, so Follow Esports, obviously, this is not the map that they want to drop by any stretch of the imagination, because we've seen... Well, I'm thinking of the old Follow Esports, which is SKDC, because they suck on Inferno.
Just putting it out there, man.
I don't mind saying it. Every time that I've seen them play, they get beat like 16-3 or 16-4 on Inferno. Like, that is not their map. But this is a different Follow Esports team, so don't have to worry about that one.
Yeah, actually, I don't think I've had a chance to see this new team play on Inferno as yet, so I'm kind of going to be blind going into this one. But a little bit of a messy take here from the members of Coastless, as a lot of team damage is actually going to be connected here. They're trying to work their short haul push. Nonetheless, they pick up their first kill, and as they work their way in, Slemmy actually still hiding. They find Ruru back over there too, but Slemmy's going to pop out, does stop the plant for a moment, but they're still going to go for it. And they're cleaning up kills left and right. FGB in charge just go crazy, picking up a combined 4 kills there within about a 5-second timer. And Coastless, they're going to pick up the pistol and maintain their lead here as they start up the T half.
This is where it starts to get a little bit scary for Follow Esports going into these anti-eco rounds. They really, really need to steal one of these rounds away. That would be massive for them. Team Coast looking at an 11-7 scoreline. If they can execute these anti-ecos properly, that would put them in a very good position going into the first gun rounds, because their gun rounds hadn't looked that bad on the CT side once they got their money stabilized, and that's exactly what they're in the process of doing here. You can see two P90s. Invert's going to stay on the pistol for this round, which is kind of a risky buy just because they went for the armor pistols on the CT's Follow Esports, and then they've also got four SMGs to work with, MAC-10 and MP7, going to be your money farmers for this one.
Yeah, Peter, of course, staying a little bit lower here on the CT side so as to be able to buy up the op there on the fourth round. They're going to work their way out. He does pick up one headshot here, trying to find another one. He does connect some good damage, which Stewie's going to be able to finish back off there by taking down FGB, but as they work their way in, Stewie only picking up one more with that scavenged P90 before he's traded out by draWsouL, leaving it with two T's left alive. Follow Esports are the man up right now. Those 5-7's going to have to do work. Ruru finding one of the two kills, and now it's just Invert pressing his way out. He is surrounded right now, looking for the trade on a Ruru, but he cannot find it, and aKis is going to shut him down. Follow Esports find the eco, and we're right back to a 1-point lead for Coastless now.
Yeah, that was huge. That was massive for Follow Esports, because now they got the money. They salvaged two SMGs. That puts them right back on a save on this terrorist side. They actually go for a buy, surprisingly enough. They put the AK in the hands of Invert. I'm going to work around that rifle buy, and the rest of them are going to go for armor pistols. So they're looking to... trade this one right back out, and Peter, he's going to get aggressive here in Connector, and he might lose his life, but he does have backup. He does find one, finds two. Stewie2k actually kills him, so not the best nade.
So, potentially another round being traded back out here, but we'll have to see how things go, as Drossel's going to work his way in, finding one headshot there, looking for another one. He's going to come down to 81 HP, but in the meantime, ScrunK is going to find this kill on Ruru as well, so... Feet, Slemmy is going to be the final player left back alive, and, well, we may just have Coastless retaking control yet again here, as Slemmy going to have to try to pull off a miracle, but he's surrounded, so draWsouL is going to get the shot to the back, he'll finish it off, and Coastless right back up to that plus two advantage there, and Follow Esports, economy's going to be in all sorts of places when you look at these five players.
To be honest, I wouldn't be surprised if Follow Esports bought here. They've got 4,300 on Peter, they've got, they had... a decent amount there on Slemmy as well, but they're going to just go for the naked pistols, P250s across the board. They're going to stack the A bomb site Look for anything that they possibly can. You can see a smoke to the top side of mid. That's going to enable these terrorist side to get out towards the top and take mid control. But if they do decide to go through connector, there is a heavy presence here from the CT side. And I don't know if Peter got spotted. Slimmy's going to fall. Peter's right there for the trade, but he doesn't overextend. And now he's just going to get swarmed on.
Now Char rolling his way back in here, picking up those supers with a P90. And at this point, yep, just forging their way through here. The NA special has ended. No longer will Eco's maybe be traded back out. Stewie's going to stop the plan. He gets a second one. Hold on. Looking for that third. But finally, FGB gets a solid aim lock onto him there to take him down. And Coastless will indeed pick up a second point here.
That's just... That's poor play there from Coastless. They didn't clear all their angles. They spotted the player up on top of balcony and assumed that underneath of it was cleared. Then nobody actually cleared that. So Stewie picking up a couple, making it a little bit more expensive there for the terrorist side. But that's just... Poor angle clearing there from Coastless. Now it's just going to be an all-out B-rush, and this is going to be a little bit scary here for Follow Esports because that's a late Molotov. That is going to be a little bit effective. They're going to jump on that window. That's FGB by himself. Char follows. They're just giving him 1v1s right now. Slemmy capitalizing on it right now, and he's got two more at the end of that smoke at Halls. They haven't found their way out. He's going to be able to spot one, spots two, so they know that they've gotten out banned. DrawSoul's going to trade that out, and Invert finds aKis. Peter with the up answers back on a DrawSoul, so we're down to a 3v2. But Peter's going to make it even harder in rooRoo. Finishes it off. So Follow Esports actually win the first full gun round, but we did have some buy-ups before, which was where those trades came from.
So Follow Esports keeping it close for the time being, but they did let Coastless get away a little bit by choosing to go for that eco there on the previous round, so not letting them get away just yet. Now picking up another round, they're going to be able to afford their buy. Same story sort of for Coastless here. Going to be definitely a broken one as they attempt to just retake the advantage and, of course, try to press it onwards by completely destabilizing that CT economy. Now with them going for a full buy-up here once again, if they can stop them before that economy gets to a good spot, then they're going to force them onto another eco, at which point they can gain an additional point advantage, and it'll be a quick attempt to take the B site, but as you can see here, members of the CT team, specifically Slemmy, doing a great job of holding off. Finally, he's traded out by Invert, but he wasted a good 5 to 10 seconds there, so that's a lot of time given to Follow Esports to get the rotate. Simply, Peter gets that shot to the face of Invert, going to shut him down. Now rolling into the site, looking for more, but two T's left. They're starting to surround him, drops the bomb carrier before he can plant it. Char does find a train once again, but now he's alone in this 1-on-3, trying to look for the kill into aKis, but aKis is going to spot him first. And Follow Esports do pick up another point here, just one more away from tying things up on Coastless.
That was a ballsy play from Peter. He actually pushed all the way around in B halls and got a couple of flank kills. One basically playing shotgun with that AWP and got one close up and was able to also prevent the plant. That was massive for them because that stops the buy. Now it's going to actually be a full eco round here from Coastless. They're not really going to invest too much. They only pick up two P250s. The rest are on Glocks. And looks like they're just going to go for a bait and switch here. Maybe push three players out through B halls, hope for the rotation off of A, and commit that bomb in to get the plant. But this is pretty much a throwaway round for Coastless.
So this will more than likely mean that the scoreline is going to end up getting tied back up to 11 points here. Coastless having all sorts of troubles keeping that round score consistent, and now Follow Esports coming off of that one with, again, three players left alive, like we said before, isn't really going to do any favors, so their economy is basically going to be stuck in the same spot it has been for the past two rounds, not being built up just yet, and Coastless realized this, so they'll probably look to, beyond getting the plan, of course, try to get as much damage as possible here into this round. They're trying to keep that money low, and if they can do that, it's going to be great, because one gun round means one eco immediately after that for the members of FE. But if they do let them escape, that money's going to build up to a very dangerous point. And obviously, they'll have a lot more work to do before they're sort of in the safe zone for picking up some more rounds and reestablishing the lead, which they've worked so hard to gain here on their opponent's map choice.
Yeah, and like I said, this being a throwaway round, FGB is just going to barrel out. They actually just barrel FGB out. Now they're going to go for the fake on the B-bomb site. That's going to pull two rotators off of A. You can actually see this flake is back towards stairs, so they might be able to sneak this. Nope, he's spotted.
And aKis, of course, picking up the flank back over there, too. The bombs are going to the floor. The rest of the T's trying to work their way back out, but Peter already lined up to stop the market push here. He finds one. He's going to pick up an additional one here. Actually, Stewie, I should mention, is going to find that kill. Was he on top of Char?
Yes, he jumped out the window and landed on Char's head, which gave it away. If he would have landed on the ground, he might not have swung around and gotten that kill, but he drops out of the window and actually lands on Char's head.
So there's going to be the tie. Again, like we said before, you mean at the very least to pick up the two kills, so they're gonna do some decent damage. But obviously, three continuous rounds with three players left alive for FE, they are going to start to stack up a little bit of money. Won't be the best, but it's starting to get a little better. And initially, at the beginning of this, Peter is going to connect a small shot on Invert. Going to hit him through the wall, I believe, so he's only going to get dropped to 80 HP. But nonetheless, they have spotted these two players in middle. What they don't know, of course, is the three players slowly working their way into the A site.
Yeah, and Follow Esports, their defensive side looking pretty good so far. They've won 4 out of the 7 rounds that have played so far. 3 rounds obviously going the way of Coast. The trades of Ecos at the beginning of this half kind of negated at this point. Obviously, pretty standard setup here. They've gotten mid control on the terrorist side. Skrunk's going to be peeking for this catwalk push, and Ruru's actually going to fall as well as Peter. So that's the AWP down, AWP on AWP battle going the way of the terrorist side. But peeking out from underpass, he's going to be able to find a frag. And FGB, I don't know what Stewie was really doing. He was looking for that player over from connector, but FGB is just going to wreck two players coming into this 8 bomb site. They're going to get the bomb down, and it's all on Slemmy. So this will be a 12-11 scoreline for Coastless.
And Slemmy, to be honest, I doubt he's really going to attempt to do all that much here in the end of the round. You can see he's only got really not a whole lot of utility. I mean, he's got a molly and he's got a smoke to work with, but in terms of finding an entry, of course, that molly and the smoke, unless he's in a good position to force that player outside, not really going to be able to net too much of that. And considering it's a 1v4, and also considering the fact that, again, as we had discussed many times previously to this, that his team's economy is not really in the best spot as of yet, will be in his own best interest as well as his team to just fall back and save this M4. They'll let Coastless retake the lead, again, only 1 point behind, so it's not the worst thing in the world. And they should still be able to get another semi-decent buy coming up into the 24th round.
Yeah, that's the big thing right here, is that hanging onto this rifle is actually pretty massive for him. They won't have to rebuy there. Slemmy doesn't really have any economy to buy up behind that, but aKis should be able to drop one. Ruru should be able to finance his own gun. And now Slemmy can actually drop that rifle over to a teammate. So you can see they are going to have a decent buy behind this. They are going to have full nade kits. So this is actually a good buy from the Follow Esports side. No AWP to work with. Peter's going to be on a FAMAS as well as Slemmy. So buying down very, very low. If they lose this, it will be a save, and they're looking at a 14-11 scoreline if Coastless can execute this round. So things a little bit dicey for the Follow Esports squad.
Coastless, they're going to go for a direct mid take here once again. Smokes in all sorts of places. Follow Esports, they're going to try to contest this from within
that nade just wrecked Ruru. That was a 94 damage nade.
So Ruru not really going to be alive for too much longer. Drossel in the meantime as well, picking up these two kills from inside a connector. Tracks it onto both Peter along with aKis to shut those players down. And as you had already mentioned, Ruru with him down at 6 HP. The defense, it's pretty much completely gone, and now with these two kills being picked up, almost a third, Coastless pretty much how they're picking as to where they want to take this take from this point forward.
Yeah, it looks like they're actually going to bring it back towards the A bomb site. There's only one player to defend, that's Stewie2k, who's actually up in the palace hall, so he might be able to do some damage here, but Invert's going to be encroaching there, so he's going to get the information, even though he's probably going to die, which is exactly what's going to happen. But now they know that Stewie2k's in there, and there's not going to be a whole lot Stewie's going to be able to do from this position. He actually picks up the AWP, so he might be able to get a one and done as they push in towards this bomb site, but he is going to come under fire very, very soon.
Stewie, he is going to leg a player there, jumped up midair. That'll be Char, but the rest of the team was spotted as well, and it's definitely not going to be worth it to go for the repeat. So picks up the M4. We'll hope to try and counter out a little bit of a rotation there, but won't even be finding it. They're forced onto the site now at this point, and FGB might have a surprise coming up behind him. Nobody watching the ticket box push at this point. So Ruru, he's actually going to find the kill over here. Now down at 6 HP, however, so he does have to be very, very careful with this push, but they're making slow progress here. They find one more player. Ruru's going to jump in. He picks up an additional kill on his Skrunk, and they find one more there, too. So it's all on draWsouL, trying to clutch out this 1v2. I believe the bomb is planted for him, so he's going to find one, but Slemmy finds the trade. And with the kid armed here, he is going to have enough time to defuse that bomb, so just barely Follow Esports are going to be able to keep that round alive, and they'll tie things up once again here at 12 points now.
That's massive for Follow Esports. I mean, that was an unlikely situation for him to win. It was 4-on-3. They had one player that was on 6 HP. Stewie just doing a great job biding his time. He pulls the distraction from CT or from the terrorist ramp by A, and allows his teammates to rotate in. Ruru actually picking up two kills there with the with 6 HP. So that's massive. That's a huge find for him. So their money's still not stabilized here on the CT side. Peter's still on that FAMAS, but it's just going to be another fast mid-strat here from the terrorist side. Drossel's going to come under fire, and Ruru drops him. That's the bomb down. aKis takes down Char, and already it's a 3-on-5. So this mid-presence kind of gets shut down this round, and Follow Esports looking to reclaim that lead again.
The pinch this time was a lot more effective than the last round. If you looked at it before, they really had only a lot of pressure coming out from connector, and obviously we saw, I believe it was Invert, they got really lucky there, picking up those two kills right in a row too, which is that one spray combo, so we got a huge spray. But this time it's coming in from window room, it's coming in from cat, it's still coming in from connector, and they really only get a good smoke in connector, so those other two are able to pop out, and they find two kills right from the get-go here, along with finding out that, yeah, it's just a full mid presence from these guys. So that's a great move from FE. They knew that Coastless were playing heavy mid in a lot of these rounds, so they take the gambit on pressing it right from the beginning, and they catch those two players, which is probably going to kill a lot of this aggression, and should make this round very much so more manageable here for FE.
Yeah, shouldn't be too much of a problem, but Skrunk hits a nice shot onto aKis, closes out that connector aggression. They actually do throw that smoke up deep as well. That smoke actually hit him, which might have stopped the stutter stepping that was going on, but ScrunK is going to push behind this. They put the bomb up there as well, and now jumping into window room. Nice shot from inVert. He's going to take Peter down, so we're equalizing on 3v3. So Coast is bringing this one back. They've only got Stewie over here by Ticket Booth to try to shut off this push, and he's hiding behind a smoke, throws the flash out. He might be able to get a peek off of this, but there you go. He's going to be able to find one. Spams the bomb planter as well, and that's huge. Now with only 5 seconds left, there's not going to be much inVert can do, and he's going to lose his life to Stewie. They're going to get the AWP out of this as well. AK to boot. Maybe? rooRoo actually doesn't pick up the AK, but Stewie's going to have that off for Peter this next round, and now they're starting to build a little bit of economy behind this on the Follow Esports side, so they're in a pretty good position. Preventing that bomb plant was huge. Coastless going to be on a save, and yeah, Follow Esports looking for 14.
That was like really awkward too as to why inVert decided to push that with only 5 seconds left with the AWP still in his arsenal as well. Is that basically fed the CTs a free AWP where he maybe could have fallen back? Yeah, if the round timer expired and he died, he wouldn't have had that much money, but they were going to be on a pretty much this round. They would have been pretty much on this buy that they were going for anyways, so it wouldn't have been the worst loss in the world, of course. Instead, now he's given the CTs a free AWP that they didn't even really have before, and that's going to be a lot more pressure that they'll have to work against in the upcoming gun rounds.
Yeah. And that's a bit of a mistake, but of course, I don't think he realized where rooRoo was at the time. aKis does get a trade, burns ScrunK. Actually, gets burned by ScrunK. Manages to find the first one. Now it's on Stewie to find these frags and draWsouL down to 1 HP. They spot him coming out, so they know that it's an A hit. There's another peek, but it's going to be the scout of inVert trying to do the damage. And the push behind this. Actually, rooRoo eats that flash, does good damage, but ScrunK takes him down, loses the bomb in the process, so Slemmy with a nice swift trade. Drossel goes down, Stewie's going to be able to find one more, and he picks up another one. So, what looked a little bit hairy at first for Follow Esports, they actually finish it off nicely, and 3 alive at the end of that round, so they get up to 14. Looking to close this one out, and still no money here for the terrorist side, as they did go for that buy round last round, so it's going to be a very difficult spot for them to be in, and they're going to be on the same exact buy again this round.
So, it'll be a big test from these guys. They have managed to pull off an eco round or two previously, but unfortunately, not really against a buy that's as full as this one now. With that free AWP still in the hands of Peter, now has full utility and a kit behind it. Everybody's got kits, I should mention, and already there, Peter inside of the palace. He's going to be able to pick up a kill onto inVert, and the rest of the team, they'll just try to make a full four-man push as it is now outside of the T-ramp, but very, very predictable indeed. We'll see how well this ends up panning out for these guys as they work their way in. There's Stewie catching one. They see the rest coming in. Second from Stewie, just hiding behind the triple stack there. And the rest of them, they don't even want to go for it. They're going to fall back, try to wrap that over towards either mid or the B site, but that'll be a very easy move to see as well from the CT side of things.
Yeah. Peter with the aggression and Halls finding a nice pick on inVert. That was only a scout that he found, but still that scout can do a lot of damage. Stewie2k playing stalwart in this A bomb site. I mean, he's sitting at the top, 26 and 18. aKis is going to find ScrunK, and he's going to go for the second one. draWsouL does dink him, but can't get the second shot off, so now we're sitting on map point for Follow Esports. This was their choice, so pretty much the result they were looking for. Maybe a little bit closer than they thought it was going to be, but Coastless had a pretty solid CT side, and their terrorist side wasn't too bad. They only picked up 3 rounds here on their terrorist side, which kind of sucks, but Follow Esports doing a good job. Now they're going to spot this mid aggression early on, and now they got to deal with it. And that's actually huge. draWsouL and Char going big this round. aKis, the only saving grace for the CTs. And now the defense for the CT side is very split. Peter up on top of Ticket Booth. He's going to get caught out. Actually missing the shots there. Only takes him to 15. Slimmy's on the rotation as well, so that should have been a kill.
And Slemmy is thankfully going to be able to finish things off there on a ScrunK after getting the initial intel from his teammate. Still going to be pressured by Char, but it doesn't matter. Finding that kill as well, so the tables are even once again. Both players, or both teams, I should say, down to 2 players at this point. But the big problem, of course, for the CTs is both are sitting at fairly low health pools. Peter at 15, Slemmy at 48. Does not leave them with a whole lot of room for error now, as the rest of Coastless do wrap back in here. They're going to plant the bomb, probably just in the default position as soon as draWsouL has done scouting things out. And Peter, after not catching any initial sort of draft coming his way, he's going to make sure to check B, so that'll put him a little bit off. But still no plan, actually. Coastless taking their jolly old time with this, so that does leave the potential here for Slemmy to catch this. Peter's still looking at B2. He hasn't heard the plant noise from this position, but he's definitely going to know it, of course, because Peter can see pretty much everything here on the B site, and when that ticking noise does start sounding, he's definitely going to know for sure that it's on that A site.
Yeah, that's the big thing. Peter is grouped up here with Slemmy to try to get this retake, but it's not very likely. He's got to hit these off shots. He's got to be massive in this round, but inVert's going to take the peek and actually finds the scout frag, and there it is. draWsouL finishes it off, so nice job there from Coastless. Good recovery to stay alive in this matchup. 15 to 13. Money is good on the CT side, so it will be another full buy. A little bit low here on the Terrorist side. You can see they're going to donate a weapon over to ScrunK. They do have a solid buy behind this regardless. The only one kind of reeling right now is going to be Char down there with just a decoy, head armor, and an AK, but shouldn't be too much of a problem. Invert's got the AWP now. Peter's got an AWP. Peter's going to go for this aggressive peek here in mid. They're just waiting for that smoke to bloom, but they peek before it, and draWsouL is going to get punished for it. So a little overzealous there in mid.
Now, again, losing a player here, not going to be the best situation in the world. You talked about it before. They were, to be completely honest, they were a little bit lucky to make it out with that last round, because that, even that still wasn't really a full buy for the T's once again. They were stretching the dollars just a little bit in that situation. Thankfully, they've gotten to a situation where now they've got an AWP along with all the rifles to work with here still, but losing one player at the beginning of the round is not what they need to have, and also getting this push spotted out as well could lead them into a couple of options, and Ruru already pressuring Cat. This is going to counter out the movement from Coastless should they still decide to move towards this angle. But it'll actually change itself up a bit. They are going to try to put a lot more players over here into the back halls, and now all this is going on. Here's Stewie, the big flank coming over through T-spawn. He's going to pick up a kill over here on a Char as well. aKis finding one, gets aggressive inside of the apartments. That's a kill that's not going to happen there just as of yet, actually, as I correct myself. aKis finds the kill just outside of the window room. Now leaving only FGB and Invert alive to try to clutch this out. They're going to go through apartments, but as we've talked about before, there's coverage here. Doesn't even check that right corner. Slemmy finds not only kill on Invert, but the kill onto FGB as well. Cleans things up, and that is going to give the first map to Follow Esports.
Yeah, that's a nice defense there. Obviously, a little bit of a bait and switch in the hallway. Slemmy's going to be able to pick up the last two. They weren't expecting that second player to be up perched there. 16-13, map choice for Follow Esports, so they do actually hold true on their map. They actually pick up that first map. And now we're going to go to Inferno, which is the opposing squad, Team Coastless. It's their choice, and they've been a little bit wishy-washy on this map in the past. They've looked really good, and they've also looked kind of not so good. So we'll see that one, but we are going to take a quick break before this one gets started up.
And you guys will take that break right about now. So stick around. We'll be back with map number 2 on Inferno in just a few minutes here at the StarLadder Star Series Season 14.